A month ago, I held my very first thesis writing masterclass. Everything you need to know to write your thesis 5 times quicker. And this was such a useful masterclass as it was able to help students who were either beginning to write their thesis or were in the middle of it, or also those that had maybe just finished. And it helped those students really try to articulate what a good thesis looks like. So I had no corrections for my PhD thesis, and actually I had one spelling correction, so that was my only correction, but I had no academic content corrections for my PhD thesis. And I truly believe that the biggest reason for this is because I understand what the examiner wants to see, and I'm preempting what they need to know, and I'm providing that information to them. So when they're actually reading the chapters of my thesis, they have already got those answers in their head, and they're not questioning what those answers could be. And so as a result, they think this is a good thesis, and so they're not considering asking any further questions. And that is truly, truly a skill. And in my masterclass, I went through all the different aspects that you need to think about when thinking about thesis writing, everything from mindset to the actual structure of every single chapter and what you have to include with examples. My next masterclass is on the 1st of October, so exactly a month from today. It's the 1st of September when I'm filming this. So exactly a month from today, I'll leave the link for it down below with a little cheeky discount because you are a viewer of this channel. But if you want to join, it would be ideal if you're someone who's writing a PhD thesis or about to start writing, or even a new PhD student, but also a master's student or an undergrad, but only if you're writing a research paper, so final year undergrad. But usually most of the people that were attending the masterclass last time were master's students and PhD students. So if you're one of those, then I think you'll find this really useful. It includes a template, so the dissertation writing template that I have from the Page Doctor. It includes that template for free as well. So it's and it's 3 hours long, so I think it's really worthwhile and it's good value for money. At the end of the masterclass, you will get the presentation slides, you'll get the recording of the masterclass, and you'll get the template, of course. So all of that can come together, so it means that you're able to go back and listen to the masterclass again and also go back and read the notes. So in this video though, I wanted to quickly kind of run through the different points. So of course, this is not equivalent of a 3-hour masterclass, but I thought it'd be useful for you to know sort of what the points are that I'll be touching upon. And also, if you are someone who is not maybe able to afford the masterclass, or maybe not able to join for whatever reason, you kind of have a brief overview as to what I'll be speaking about anyway. So the first thing you need to do is consider the purpose and the components of a thesis. Now that could be a master's thesis, a PhD thesis. I did compare them both, and really thinking about what the examiner's criteria are. So once you understand what that mark scheme looks like, you know what it is that you need to produce at the end. And this is something that I always say to students: if you have an essay, if you have an assignment, if you have a report, look at the mark scheme. Even from GCSE, from A level, from secondary school, you have a mark scheme for a reason. It is what the examiners are using as their ballpoint, and you know, they're using this as a point of kind of comparison to make sure that they are marking in a comparative and similar way. And that is available for you as a PhD student, as a master's student as well. So use that, compare it, look at it, and say to yourself, they are looking for independent thoughts. Have I got that in my thesis? They are looking for justification of methods. Have I got that in my thesis? So that was one of the first things that we did. The next thing was the biggest chunk of the masterclass, so really over an hour and a half, was looking at the structure for every single chapter of your report. So we're starting from the acknowledgements page, from the you know, the abstract, the contents page, and then going into the lit review, the introduction, the methods, the results. And what we did was we looked at the structure of every single part of them, but not just the overarching structure, but even the paragraph structure. So we really looked at, let's say you're writing an introduction, or let's say you're writing the results. That first paragraph, what should it look like? That first sentence, what should it look like? When you're creating diagrams, when you're creating figures, what does that look like? And that was all encompassed within that kind of section of the masterclass. And it's really important to have that structure because, you know, if you're wanting to write a thesis quickly, you need to have some sort of consistent theme that you are sticking by to help you, and also to to kind of tell yourself, right, I need to make sure I'm justifying at every single point. I need to make sure that I am being clear with what I'm referring to at every single point. So having those things in mind means that you're always doing it, and that means that the examiner isn't thinking about what you're referring to. It's just all clear for everybody involved. Another thing you want to think about when writing a thesis quickly is referencing and using a citation manager or referencing manager. I have spoken about Mendeley on this channel so many times, and I think Mendeley is a great platform for you to be able to use for referencing, as you can, you know, read your research papers, you can bookmark them, and then you're able to export that list onto Word as you're writing. So this is, I think it's just so easy to use, and I don't know why anyone would do referencing manually in 2023, but if you're still doing referencing manually, then please go to Mendeley, download it, and use it as your tool. There are others as well, Zotero, there's EndNote. You can use those too, but just finding what works for you and sticking to that. Another thing you want to think about when writing a thesis quickly is how to overcome procrastination and how to overcome things like writer's block. When you're writing a thesis, you're writing thousands and thousands of words, you're analyzing, you're reading literature, you're bringing things and ideas together. And what can happen is natural, and it's very normal to feel blocked. It's very normal to feel like, I don't know what I'm saying, I don't know what I'm writing, I don't even know what to write anymore. That's so normal. But what you need to do in those situations is have some sort of method that you can use to overcome that stage, right? The same way that an author, you know, when writing a literature book gets stuck, you know, they have their thoughts, they're not able to articulate, they're not able to bring new ideas on paper. That can happen to you as a PhD student too. And one of the ways that I recommend is having a procrastination list. And this is a list that actually is, you know, a list of tasks that you can do when you're just not feeling down to writing. So, you know, I don't wanna write, I'm not in the mood to write right now, but what I don't mind doing is I don't mind collating these figures, I don't mind making my diagrams look good, I don't mind getting the legends together, I don't mind screenshotting some of my images from my microscopic data, whatever it is. Some of those tasks that you don't mind doing, they're not too strenuous. You can have like music in the background, you can have a movie in the background. They don't require like, they're quite repetitive. We all have like those repetitive tasks that we can do. And then we'll save the hard thinking, sort of, you know, writing time for when we are in the mood. So that's one of the techniques that I shared in the masterclass. Another thing we spoke about is editing and how to edit your thesis at the end of, you know, when you finish writing. And of course you can send it to a proofreader, you can send it to someone who edits professionally, like at the Page Doctor. We would edit it for you, of course, and leave you feedback and provide you with support to be able to improve it. But if you are not able to send it to us for whatever reason, time constraints, etc., you can edit it yourself. One of the main ways that you can do this and kind of, I guess, provide yourself an edit is by ensuring that things match up within your thesis. And that is the biggest, I mean, spelling is normal, grammatical errors are pretty normal, even I'm sure I still have some now that I've printed out. But usually things that we look out for are consistency and making sure that things actually make sense. So rereading it out loud, making sure that your figure numbers match up to the writing and the text that you've mentioned it in, making sure that you've got good legends there, making sure that your figures are all labeled, making sure that, you know, your formatting is right. All of those things are tasks that you need to do at the end of thesis writing that don't take very long, but actually do make an overall impact on how your thesis looks and sounds. This is another important aspect that we covered during the masterclass, and it's the use of AI in thesis writing. And it's controversial. I think, you know, loads of us think that we shouldn't be using it. It's unethical, it's cheating, it's plagiarism, etc. But actually there are ways of using it where beyond the thesis writing, where you're thinking about connecting papers together, finding like limitations within papers, finding like ideas and future work, and even things like improving your titles or your subtitles. You can use ChatGPT for something like that. And we were able to go through different AI platforms that I'd recommend using. And these are changing all the time, by the way. The next masterclass will be different to the last one in terms of the AI, because there's so many popping up all the time. So that was something that we talked about as well. And you know, if you're in academia and you haven't yet got grasp of AI and how you can use it, then this could also be very helpful. And last but not least, we spoke about structuring using a template, and this is using a blank template. So I've actually developed a blank thesis template. So it's a Word template. You can use it on Google Docs or you can use it on Microsoft Word as well. It's a blank template and it includes all the hyperlinked chapters. So it's linked up to the contents page. So if you were to change like what page it ends up on, it will automatically change the page number for you on the contents page. And it just gives you like a canvas, it's not a blank canvas, but a canvas where you can begin and you can begin writing and you can begin to actually put your information into the right chapters. And it's just somewhere to start. If you're someone that doesn't quite like to start on a completely blank page, it's a good place to begin. So yeah, if you want to join, that's sort of the main contents of what we're going to be covering in the session. I had amazing reviews, amazing, like I was absolutely beaming at the end of the session. I'm really glad that people enjoyed it. You can also book a one-to-one session with me after the session. So if you want to speak to me in person, just, you know, outside of the group, you can book that as well. But anyway, I will leave the link down below for everything. So yeah, go and check it out. And I'm excited to see more of you there for the next session, which is in exactly 1 month's time. See you then. Bye.